He won't say he's sorry. He won't call it murder. The so-called butcher of Borough Park is talking about the killing of a young boy, for which he's accused. 35-year-old Levi Aaron allegedly lured 8-year-old Libby Kletsky off the streets, then reportedly panicked. The New York Daily News visited Aaron in his cell on Rikers Island and has the exclusive. Asked repeatedly if he wanted to apologize, the confessed child killer kept looking away and remained silent. At one point, he nodded his head, but wouldn't say he was sorry. Aaron never once spoke the name of Libby Kletsky. He referred to the moment when he smothered the boy and carved him up as the incident. New York's WNYW reports Aaron is on suicide watch inside his jail cell and has more insight on his interview with the Daily News.
Aaron has pleaded not guilty and has been declared competent to stand trial, but he did tell the news that he hears voices. He says he mostly stays in bed in his cell here at Rikers Island. And the paper also asked him if he wished he'd never met 8-year-old Libby, and he told them sometimes.
The blog WNYC notes psychiatrists say Aaron has a personality disorder described as being blank. The evaluation, which depicted the accused murderer as being flat and apathetic, was first obtained by the Associated Press and later confirmed to WNYC by Aaron's attorney. The court-ordered psychiatric evaluation also revealed that Aaron had a sister who was institutionalized for schizophrenia. But Aaron is apparently self-aware enough to be despondent. WNBC has his defense attorneys appeal to the judge.
At this time, we're going to move that the defendant be put on suicide watch and be kept in protective custody for his own safety while he's in the system. If I may add, Your Honor, the defendant has also indicated to me some despondency, and I'm very concerned for his well-being.
Should an insanity defense even be allowed? In an editorial, the Daily News says, insane or not, Aaron should not go free if found guilty. The insanity defense has become less about compassion for the mentally ill than a loophole for criminals to escape through. Insanity in a courtroom is not the same as the colloquial expression. It is equally distinct from the way psychiatrists use the term, which, in fact, they rarely do. A pretrial hearing is set for October 14th. I'm Logan Tittle for Newsy. Multiple sources, the real story.